Mom!
Yes, Milo?
Just come and sit down for a moment.
OK.
A whoopee cushion. Very funny.
A customer.
Ta-da!
Hi, Horatio.
Horatio? Is he here?
You are Horatio.
Oh, yes. So I am. Good day to you all. Whoops! How did that get in there?
I don't know, Horatio. And what can we do for you today?
My clown outfit needs a clean. Making an audience laugh is the most magical thing you can think of. But it's a messy old business. There's an old saying in the circus world. The bigger the custard pie, the louder the laughter. And my custard pies are huge.
Well, it sounds like we need to get you cleaned up before your next show.
Magic! Gotta go.
We'll take these to Suds, Dad. Hi, Suds.
Oh, hello. And what do you have for me today, my bubbly buddies?
A clown's outfit, Suds.
Aha! That explains the custard! Getting these clean will be no joke.
Suds, do you have any clown outfits we can wear?
Let me see.
With torn trousers, I need to get them mended. But the show's about to start. What am I gonna do?
Why don't we do your clown act for you?
You? You do look like clowns, but can you make people laugh? Splendid! You're hired! Oh, I'm gonna miss being out there in the circus ring. When the audience laughs with you, it's the best sound in the world.
Oh, I think the audience are taking their seats.
Oops. Wow!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the circus! Our first act will have you gasping in wonder. It's the amazing Eleanor and my prop Dubois on the flying trapeze!
Wow! The Dubois are amazing.
Let's practice our clown act.
Smell my flower, Lofty.
I didn't mean to trip. It's these big shoes.
Next into the ring, our very own Perilous Poultry. Please welcome Farmer Tilly and her stunt chicken! Ready to laugh like you've never laughed before. Here are the funniest clowns in town, Lofty, Lark, and Milo!
Oh, that's very funny, isn't it, girls?
My shoes.
Yes, but it was funny.
It wasn't funny for me.
Clowns are meant to make people laugh.
But I don't want to be laughed at. I don't like it.
Where are these clowns then?
Just one second, folks.
I can't go out there. I might trip on these shoes again, and everyone will laugh at me. I'm the worst clown ever.
No, you're not. I love laughing with you.
With me?
Yes, with you. It's like Horatio said, when the audience laughs with you, it's the best sound in the world.
Being laughed with sounds much nicer than being
my three little clowns get on, eh?
Oh, Suds, it was the best!
We had to do a clown act at the circus.
I didn't want to be laughed at.
But when Milo heard the crowd laughing with him, he couldn't get enough.
When I grow up, I think it'll be amazing to be a clown!
Okay, now star jumps. One, two, three, four. And now, running on the spot. That's right. Keep your knees up.
A customer!
time for a sit down. Oh, that's nice.
Wow! If it isn't Captain Skipper Stone! How can we help?
Slight soup stain on the starboard side. Things got a little choppy at sea last night.
Were you driving a boat?
I was captaining a cruise ship, young fellow. Criss-crossing the ocean, stopping off at the world's most fascinating places.
Amazing!
You may call it amazing. I call it just another day at sea, giving my passengers the voyage of their lives.
Oh, Dad and I went on a cruise once. Loved every minute. Until Dad got seasick. Anyway, let's get that outfit cleaned for you.
The ocean calls. Cheerio!
We'll take this to Suds, Mum. Hi, Suds.
Oh, hi, Milo. What have you got for me today?
It's a cruise ship captain's outfit, Suds.
Aha! I thought I could detect seaweed and salty air. It's full steam ahead to get these cleaned.
Suds, do you have any...
cruise ship captain's outfits? Let me see.
Sailing, you do the relaxing. Bye for now, shipmates.
Hi, Captain Stone.
Ah, you must be my new crew. The last lot still have the sniffles after a long cruise to the Arctic. Follow me. Welcome aboard the Spirit of the Ocean.
Whoa, the ship's steering wheel.
And a big red button.
That is the ship's horn. It lets everyone know we're setting sail. And sail we shall. All the way to Ancient Island, a place full of history and wonder.
I hope there's a gift shop.
Ancient Island must be that way.
I can see you're a great navigator. We'll be sure to go the right way when you're around. And your cheery smile would keep everyone happy. You'd make an excellent entertainment officer.
Me next? What can I be?
Why, with that hat, you'd be captain of the whole ship. Although, as all captains know, it takes a crew to sail a ship. Now, watch the bridge, young Captain Milo. I need to make sure the last of the passengers are safely aboard.
A great view from here.
Ah! What was that?
It might have been this.
Ah!
Oh!
Oh. Oh. Milo, you just made the ship go.
Make it go back again. I'm not sure how to.
Excuse me, Captain. How long till we arrive at Ancient Island? Mycroft can't wait to visit the gift shop.
She's not the only one.
Will there be aerobics?
We'll be at Ancient Island as quickly as we can.
Will we?
And our entertainment officer will do the aerobics.
Oh, that's me. Okay then, follow me.
You really are the captain now, Milo.
Yes, I am. Then let's set sail for Ancient Island.
Woo! Oh, I can see a ship over to the west and a whale to the east. I can see everything with these. Oh! Ah!
Can I have a look, please, Navigator Lark?
Okay, Captain Milo. But just a quick go.
Oh, there's a ship.
and a whale.
Yes, I know.
Arms in the air, step to the side. Arms in the air, step to the side.
Look at Lofty. That looks fun.
Arms to the sea, arms to the sky. Reach down low, reach up high.
Let me have a go, Lofty. Arms to the sea, arms to the sky.
Reach down low, reach up high.
Aerobics are fun.
They were fun.
Land ahoy, everyone. We're about to arrive at
Ancient Island.
Wonderful.
It was my job to say that.
OK, everyone, get ready for your tour of the island. Please, gather over here and follow...
Captain Milo, this way to Ancient Island.
But that's my job.
Magnifique, Captain Milo!
It's such a wonderful gift shop.
Oh, I wanted to go to the gift shop.
Being a cruise ship captain is brilliant. You get to do all the fun stuff.
Huh. I don't want to alarm anyone, but is there a storm over there?
Oh.
You'll be stealing the ship, Captain.
Yes. Oh, I can handle this. I'm Captain Milo. Which way do I go?
Do you think he's okay?
Worried, Captain?
It's all fine. Everything's ship-shape. Ah!
Ah! You can't do it all by yourself, Milo.
You're right, Lark. I'm sorry. I just got carried away being captain. Oh, but just like Captain Stone said, it takes a crew to sail a ship. Will you help me?
Do you promise to let us do our jobs?
And not take over?
I promise. Are we shipmates again?
Aye, aye, Captain!
We had the most exciting cruise.
And here's a special something for you, Entertainment Officer Lofty.
A gift from the gift shop. Thanks.
Thank you for returning my ship, young sailors, and through the worst storm I've seen in years.
All thanks to a brilliant crew.
So, how was life on the ocean waves?
Suds, it was brilliant. I steered the ship. Lark showed us the way.
Then we sailed into a scary storm, but Lofty kept everyone happy.
And we all got home safe,
thanks to the best crew ever. When I grow up, I think it'll be amazing to be a...
cruise ship captain!
Yeah.
glasses.
My turn!
How do I look?
The customer!
Ouch!
Oh, hello, Queen Mabel. And what can we clean for you today?
One's monarch's robes need a good clean, if you'd be so kind.
What's a monarch?
It's another word for king or queen, Lofty. And we never stop. Today, I opened a new garden centre. Then, I handed out some glittering awards. Then, I gave a couple of interviews. And finally, I hosted a charming royal tea party.
Wow!
Oh, that does sound like hard work. Let's get that outfit cleaned for you.
Toodaloo!
We'll take these to Suds Mall. Hi, Suds.
Hello, my bubbly buddies. What are we washing today?
A monarch's outfit, Suds.
Ah, yes. The finest fabric, the softest silk. These will need my extra delicate setting. And quickly, or I'll be in royal trouble.
Suds, do you have any monarch's outfits we can wear?
Let me see.
At the docks.
I'll get you there as quick as I can, King Milo.
Royal limo coming through!
Welcome to my humble dockside, King Milo.
Thanks, Captain Stone. Oh, is this the ship that needs a name?
Indeed it is. Please, be my guest.
What are you going to call it, King Milo?
I don't know.
Good idea. Oh, what about me?
Oh, yes.
That's
a funny name. I name this ship
the Queen Mabel.
Oh, splendid choice. And freezing.
Use this.
Thank you, King Milo. I'll just go and find my spare uniform.
Oh, we'd better go, King Milo. You're here to open a new self-checkout machine at the supermarket.
Not so fast, King Milo. Just need to give this carpet a sweep. Won't be a moment. I've broken my broomstick. Now what? My orders were to get this carpet spotless for the monarch.
Here, Mrs. Sweep. Use this.
This is the blingiest broom I've ever seen. Thank you, Your Highness.
I declare this checkout open.
Oh, oh no. Yeah!
Ah! Unexpected hat in the bagging area.
Busy making food for the party.
Festive, Pierre, festive!
Is everything all right, Chef Pierre?
Oh, King Milo, I'm running a little bit behind with the party food. I haven't even mixed the cake.
Why don't we help you?
Oh, but a king cannot make his own party food.
This one can.
Without your help, I just need to bake the cake before the party.
Your party guests will be arriving very soon.
Bye!
Look at all those people!
How do I look?
Not as royal as you did earlier.
Oh, I gave away the cape and the scepter. And where's my crown gone?
Starting.
What sort of king doesn't have a crown for a royal garden party? The worst one ever.
Presenting King Milo the First.
Hello. Nice to meet you.
Queen Mabel, you're back.
Of course. I never miss a garden party.
Oh. You've come without the crown, cape and scepter.
I'm so sorry, Queen Mabel. I lost them.
She gave the cape to Captain Stone to keep warm.
And fixed Mrs. Sweep's broom with a scepter.
Well, it sounds like you put helping people first. It takes more than a crown to make a monarch, remember?
King Milo, we've brought back your things.
Thanks ever so much, Your Majesty, for letting me use them.
Still no crown? But don't worry, I've got loads of spares.
Buffet coming through! Who wants to cut the cake?
Over to you, King Milo.
The crown!
How did it get in there?
I think it was a mix-up in the kitchen. A mix-up in the kitchen.
Jolly well done, King Milo!
Yes!
Oh, and how did my mini monarchs get on?
Oh, Suds, it was brilliant! We had lots of royal engagements.
But along the way, King Milo gave away some important royal things. He even lost his crown.
But it was okay because we lost them when he was helping people. Which is what being a king is all about.
When I grow up, I think it would be amazing to be a monarch!
Patty?
Mmm, yummy.
A customer!
Hello, Chef Pierre. What can we do for you today?
Bonjour. Could you clean my chef's whites? It has been a very busy day at my restaurant.
I can tell.
Snack time at Scrubby's, I see.
We're having cheese and tomato sandwiches.
Oh, there is nothing finer than the humble cheese and tomato sandwich, in my humble opinion. Shall I tell you the secret of truly captivating cookery?
Yes, please.
Simple food, perfectly prepared. The creamiest cheese, the juiciest tomatoes, the softest bread. Mwah! Perfection.
Wow.
Oh, you're making me peckish, Chef Pierre. Let's get that outfit clean for you. Then it's an early lunch for me.
Cheerio!
We'll take this to Suds, Mum.
Hello. And what have we got here?
It's a chef's outfit.
Oh, my senses are detecting pea form, cauliflower coulis, and carrot tartare. Oh, very fancy food. Leave it with me.
Do you have any more chef's outfits, Suds?
We want to get cooking.
Let me see what I can rustle up.
A nightmare, Milo. I have run out of sprouts. And we have a very important person dining with us today. Sprout soup is my signature dish.
Why don't you go and get some more?
Then who will look after my restaurant?
We will!
Could you? Well, you do look like chefs, and I need my sprouts. Okay, then.
Yes!
If you're going to run my restaurant, you must know the secret of truly captivating cooking. It is simple food,
perfectly prepared.
Good luck, my friends. My restaurant's reputation is in your hands.
Lark, can you take the customer's orders and Lofty so we make the food?
Yes, Chef!
Ooh, ingredients. What have you got, Lofty?
Achoo! Flour!
Please, may I take your orders, please?
Lemon, onion, mush, what do you call it?
Coming right up. The customers would like 1 lemon ricotta tagliatelle, 1 apple and onion sausages with mashed sweet potato, 2 couscous and crab apple salads, and some sardine and seaweed sushi. Oh, and a slice of gluten-free chocolate cake. Got it?
I think so.
What are we making then?
Something with lemons, I think, and maybe some
seaweed.
But we're top chefs. Whatever we make will be delicious, right?
If you say so, Chef.
The food's ready, Lark. Being a chef is fun.
Oh, really?
Is this what I ordered?
Oh, there must be a new chef. Standards do seem to be slipping.
It's Queen Mabel. She must be the very important person.
Good afternoon. I've heard marvellous things about this restaurant. I thought I'd see what all the fuss was about. Table for one, if you please.
Certainly, Mrs. Queen. I mean, Your Royal Mabel. Follow me, please.
Who keeps playing those trumpets?
I can't decide. Just bring me a lunch fit for a queen. And do be quick. One is absolutely starving.
Leave that to us, Your Excellency.
But a lunch fit for a queen isn't on the menu.
That's what she asked for.
We'll just have to be creative. Chef Pierre is counting on us.
What do queens eat anyway?
Really, really fancy food. Ooh, maybe there's something in one of these cookbooks. Not fancy enough. Oh, nearly fancy enough. Oh, now this looks fancy. Let's make this for Queen Mabel.
Yes, Chef!
Is everything all right in there?
Oh, quite all right, Your Majestic Ladyship. Maybe Dave can play some music while you wait.
It's not really looking like the picture. Pass me those ingredients. One extra large tomato, two avocados, and a sprinkle of extra spicy chili powder. I hope it tastes better than it smells. Ooh, Lofty, you can be the official taster.
Oh, can I? Do I have to?
It's really extra spicy. Maybe I put in too much chili.
Queen Mabel says she's very hungry and will it be much longer?
Tell her that it's nearly ready and it'll be worth the wait. This isn't a lunch fit for a queen. But what can we give Queen Mabel? We've used everything. Apart from some cheese and bread.
Oh,
and some tomatoes. Maybe we were trying too hard to be fancy.
You can keep your glamour. I'm just happy with my trusty...
I can't wait any longer. I must go somewhere else.
No. Worry not, Your Majesty. Let me make you my famous sprout soup.
Sprouts? On a Tuesday? No, thank you.
No sprouts?
Your royal lunch is served.
Is this a...
It's a cheese and tomato sandwich, Queen Mabel.
How unusual. This is absolutely and completely delicious. It's simple,
but perfectly prepared.
I shall recommend this establishment to all of my royalist chums.
Merci, Milo. I must put your cheese and tomato sandwich on the menu straight away.
Ahem, I'd like to change my order. A cheese and tomato sandwich, please.
Me too.
Sandwiches here.
Coming right up.
Did you all have fun?
Oh, yes, Suds. Working in a restaurant is really hard work and very messy.
Especially when we cooked a spicy dish for a queen.
Ooh. But food doesn't need to be fancy.
It just needs to be good.
Well, it sounds like you had lots of fun.
When I grow up, I think it'll be amazing to be a chef. Let's make a den in here.
Milo, what are your mum and dad doing?
What does it look like we're doing?
Wow, nice dancing.
Mum, Dad.
Come on, come and join in.
A customer!
Phew.
Hello. Oh, hello.
Hi, Raymond. You look very, dusty.
Oh, I have you know, this is royal dust from the royal castle. I've been taking visitors to see how Queen Mabel lives. We see the royal paintings and the expensive royal vases. And, of course, there's the royal gift shop.
Wow! I love gift shops.
Well, Raymond, sounds like we need to get that outfit nice and clean for the Queen.
Terrific. Cheerio.
We'll take this to Suds, Mum.
Such a helpful boy.
Hi, Suds.
Oh, hello, my bubbly buddies. What have you got for me today?
It's a tour guide's outfit, Suds.
Ah, yes. I'm detecting history and a lot of furniture polish. I'll guide this towards a soapy wash on the delicate setting.
Suds, do you have any tour guides outfits we can wear?
Oh, let me see.
Sorry, folks. The historic royal castle tour's off. I've got a van full of deliveries to do and the mail must be delivered.
Oh?
That's frightfully disappointing.
That's a shame.
We've all been queuing for ages. If only there was someone else who could give us the tour.
Sounds like a job for us, Raymond.
Oh, are you sure?
They look like tour guides to me.
You know, you're not wrong, Leonard. Okay, tour guides, here's a map. It's over to you.
Yes!
I'm sure your new tour guides will show you a side of history that people never normally see. Toodaloo!
Let's go! Hello, welcome to the grand tour of Queen Mabel's royal castle. Our first stop will be
the Royal Hallway.
This is where Queen Mabel keeps her, royal umbrellas. And her,
and her royal suits of armour.
I like them.
Marvellous.
Excuse me. We will see Queen Mabel, won't we?
I'm sure she's in here somewhere.
Oh, very good.
I can't wait to see you.
Let's go and see. The next stop on the tour is the Royal Living Room.
Well, I never.
Oh, how fascinating.
This is where Queen Mabel sits on the royal sofa and watches the royal telly.
And does her royal jigsaw puzzles.
Oh, I'm partial to a puzzle, you know.
No touching, please.
Yes, right you are.
Where is Queen Mabel?
You said she'd be in here.
She doesn't seem to be in the living room at the moment.
Oh, too bad. What a shame.
That's a shame.
I'm really, really disappointed.
But she might be in the next room. It's the royal kitchen.
With the royal fridge.
The royal sink.
And the royal custard creams.
Oh, now you're talking.
No eating the royal snacks, please.
No sign of the Queen, though.
Aha! I'm sure we'll see her in the next room.
Welcome to the Royal Throne Room!
A little gaudy for my taste, but each to their own.
Ooh! Check out the bling!
No sitting on the royal throne, please.
Oh?
I can't help but notice that we're still missing a certain...
Queen Mabel?
You assured us that she was here.
Let's keep looking. Where to next, Lark?
That looks like the end of the tour.
The end?
Are you sure?
No sitting on the royal throne. Where are we?
These must be the secret royal tunnels, dear boy. Every castle has them.
But how do we get out? Which way do we go?
Don't ask me, old chap. You're the tour guide.
Okay. Let's try this way.
Maybe another way.
This way.
I'm sure we've passed that cobweb before.
Milo, I think we're lost.
You're right. What sort of tour guides get themselves lost? Not very good ones.
We still haven't had a peep of Queen Mabel.
Excuse me. Can someone turn the music down? Milo's trying to think.
We're not playing any music.
Well, if we're not playing that music...
Who is?
I don't think the tour's finished yet. Follow me.
We're tour guides, Your Royal Ladyship.
And our group really want to meet you.
You had better come in then.
Welcome to my party vault.
Oh, I like it.
Thank you. It's new. I was just testing out the sound system.
Delivery for Queen Mabel.
Yes! It's the Royal Disco Hits Volume 39. Well, it looks like we're having a party. My first one in the Royal Party Vault.
Oh, this is definitely a side of royal history that no one has seen before. Well done.
I'll say, this has been a most spectacular tour.
Yes! Put one's hands in the air like one just doesn't care.
Aha! And how did my little tour guides get on?
Oh, Suds, we loved it. We showed visitors around the royal castle.
They all wanted to see Queen Mabel, but we couldn't find her and got lost in some passages.
But then we found the Queen in her royal party vault. And we all had a disco. The best tour ever.
When I grow up, I think it would be amazing to be a
tour guide.
You'll go, Lofty. Oh.
You're putting me off.
How are we putting you off?
By watching me. Okay, then we promise we won't look.
A customer!
Yes!
Hello, Eleanor.
Hello, Mycroft. What can we do for you today?
Our dancers' outfits could do with a clune. We've just finished a very energetic rehearsal.
Phew.
That sounds like fun.
Oh, it is. We've cha-cha-cha'd, we've sambered down, and Mycroft even had a quick twirl.
I did.
Wow!
He loves to twirl, but he has to be careful. Don't you, Mycroft?
Oh, yes. My back's not as bendy as it was.
Well, let's get those outfits clean, shall we?
Thank you.
Cheerio.
We'll take these to Suds, Mum.
Hello, my bubbly buddies. What needs cleaning today?
Their dancer's outfit, Suds.
So I see. I'd better do the soapy salsa on these. Cha-cha-cha,
Suds, do you have any spare dancers' outfits?
Give me a more twinkle toes.
Keep perfect time.
But we won't if we don't keep practicing. It's our dance spectacular tonight.
Ooh!
So if you could clear the stage, please. We need to practice.
A dance spectacular sounds, spectacular.
Oh, yes. The theater will be full. We can't let our audience down.
We could be your backing dancers.
We know lots of dance moves.
And have the outfits.
Not for this show, I'm afraid. Maybe next time.
Well, we could give you an audition, I suppose.
Yes!
Let's start with some ballet. And
just
one,
feel
two, three,
the
one,
music.
Two, three.
Let your bodies
one,
move
two, three,
to
one,
the rhythm.
Two, three.
I can't do it when people are watching.
Me neither.
I can't move.
Ta-da!
I think you might need just a little more practice.
Oh.
Why don't you go and practice in the rehearsal room backstage?
Okay.
And don't be shy. Just dance like nobody's watching.
We'll try.
A one, two, three.
A one, two, three.
One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three.
Ooh.
Wow.
Look at all those different. different dance styles.
Ha ha! Music!
Let's play something more exciting.
How about this?
Have you been fiddling with the playlist again, Mycroft?
Wasn't me, but check me out!
Let's try something else. Something?
Oh!
I heard that.
Ah, my back!
Oh, Mycroft, I told you to be careful. You should have done your high kicks like this. My back!
Oh no! It's a dance disaster. We can't perform like this.
It's far too late to find replacement dancers. And no dancers means no show.
We could be your dancers.
We have been practicing.
Oh, this should be a fabulous show.
Oh, yes.
The audience is here.
The show must go on, Eleanor.
And they have been practicing. You're on!
Yay! That's a lot of people.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, in a change to our program, we have not two, but three dancers tonight. Prepare to be dazzled and amazed by the Dance Spectacular!
Don't worry, Lofty, we'll be fine.
Just dance like nobody's watching.
Thank you.
You were fabulous! What moves, what style!
Thank you so much for saving our show. You were spectacular.
Yes!
Well, did you move your feet to the rhythm of the beat?
Oh, Suds, it was brilliant!
Dancing in front of people can be scary, but not if you pretend they're not there.
Just dance like nobody's watching.
When I grow up, I think it'd be amazing to be a
dancer!